Ah, Commander. As you can see, our situation is shockingly grim.
No. It isn't ready. It hasn't been tested. We don't even know if it works.
No, sir. 12 months ago, I was put in charge of a top secret project. For you see, sir, time is on our side.
Glad to have you on board, sir.
You must listen to me. Nothing is as it should be. No, touch nothing.
You ready to send those commies running back to their mommies?
If I knew anything, I would tell you!
This war should never have happened. We went back in time to save ourselves and everything changed.
While we were busy fighting the Red Menace, this Empire of the Rising Sun was secretly preparing for war.
It appears that the Empire has mounted a full-scale assault.
They are assembling a joint task force to attack our mainland.
You will bow before us, or you will cease to exist.
This is unbelievable.
You're not a cop. You're not anybody. You're not good and you're not bad. You blend and you listen and you don't trust anyone. Once you go under, you're on your own. Any questions? Keep your eyes open.
These guys play for keeps.
You want to run with us? Prove I can trust you.
I like your attitude.
I want you to do a thing for me.
All yours, dog.
This is all gonna come crashing down.
Fuel is a groundbreaking game. You can do what you want to do with complete freedom, a rebel style.
The story behind Fuel is an alternate present. Global warming has really changed the climate and added a lot of strong climate events like tornadoes, storms. A bunch of crazy drivers are going for it into these extreme conditions to find more extreme racing than ever.
I think it's the very first time in a car racing game you can really go where you want.
It's 14,000 square kilometers of racing terrain. It's all seamless. You can drive everywhere at any point. In no other racing game you can do that. Fuel features a full range of weather effects. We've got night and day, strong weather effects like tornado, sandstorm, thunderstorm. All these weather effects change in real time during the race, and they force the player to change his route depending on the weather conditions.
For the tornado, what is interesting, it's very lively to see this in the game, and it's sometimes frightening for the player. Every part of the background that is destructible will be blown by the tornado, and part of those objects will be thrown on the direction of the player. One thing in the game that makes me excited, it will be the feeling of freedom I've never seen in any other game. You can go everywhere you want, and it creates a feeling as a player very different from everything you have ever seen. Tomorrows, and I stand inside
today.
Fracture. Tell me about it. You've been playing this, David.
Fracture is the new LucasArts game. The gimmick here is you have terrain deformation, which means you can basically move the terrain around. You can make it up to be hills, you can take it down to be ditches and things, and you've got grenades which sort of affect the terrain rather than just sort of blow up. So you can blow up and make a huge hill while you're doing it.
Now, correct me if I'm wrong, but this is an exceptionally good-looking game.
It is a pretty good-looking game. This is the beginning opening cinematic here, which will then go on into gameplay, but yeah, it's pretty nice-looking. That's the sci-fi kind of look, big shoulders, blinking armor.
It reminds me of the kind of epic design, though. I mean, what is it with kind of like chunky armor with kind of big puffy bits around the shoulders?
It looks cool.
It kind of does, but it's also kind of been done to death. I mean, I suppose on the American side of things, you know, American action games, it's all about, you know, huge chunky armor bits, and Japanese action games, it's all about being kind of like nimble and skinny. Where's the balance? That's what I want to know. Where's the balance?
You want a nimble and skinny, hunky, chunky American?
No. I just want someone who looks relatively normal. Like, you know, because, you know, just because we're in the future doesn't necessarily mean that, you know, kind of like we all run around wearing stupid armor.
It might.
No, it really doesn't. I honestly don't believe it does, you know. And also, you know, what possible function could that armour serve other than to... Well, it's certainly not going to protect him from anything.
Well, his head's exposed for a start.
Exactly. So his head's exposed, you know, because, well, that's probably a good idea. Otherwise, we'd be like, you know, Master Chief. Just got about as much personality as onion gravy. But no, honestly, like... you know, his head's exposed, so it doesn't really serve any purpose. I just wish things looked a bit more functional, you know, in these games. I think that would kind of, like, you know, allow you to sink in a little bit more to its kind of, you know, its setting, its universe, if you like. I just think, you know, it's kind of, it's just a bit too much sacrifice of style in terms of that kind of design.
So it's more the Mass Effect school of thought.
Well, you know, Mass Effect was deliberately tongue-in-cheek. It kind of deliberately harked back to that kind of like that notion that in the sort of mid-80s when they were making sci-fi that, you know, sort of like everyone would be wearing this kind of shiny plastic, a bit like, you know, Stormtroopers in Star Wars and stuff like that. And so that was more of a kind of homage to that style, you know, the Battlestar Galactica style, the clean lines, the Data 72 typeset, you know, that kind of thing. But this is just, it's more of a kind of copycat thing. Anyway, I hear it's a very, very good game.
It is a very, very good game, and the combat, as you can see, is pretty frantic, but it's also very, very, very fun.
Yeah. Look out for our review in this issue.
This fall, two worlds collide, and combat begins again.
Fight!
Mortal Kombat versus DC Universe, which side will you choose? Thank you.
Welcome to the Great Games Convention Battle of the Bands, where last week Monsters of Rock, Guitar Hero World Tour and Rock Band 2 squared up for a shredding showdown. But first, let's recap on the story so far. The original Guitar Hero first stormed the PlayStation 2 charts in November 2005. A collaboration between Rhythm Action Master Harmonix and Peripherals Whiz Red Octane. Gamers celebrated by making complete fools of themselves. Maybe that was just us. But in May 2006, the chart-topping duo dramatically split when Activision swooped for Red Octane, with MTV gobbling up Harmonix that September. Meanwhile, Guitar Hero 2 went stratospheric on PS2 and 360, but with Harmonix gone, Red Octane turned to Tony Hawk developer Neversoft for lead guitar duties on the sequel, powering out Guitar Hero 3 Legends of Rock in October 2007. Just 1 month later, Harmonix stole back the initiative with Rock Band, adding vocals and drums into the mix, and giving an even better excuse for ritual humiliation. After two more Guitar Hero spin-offs, one dedicated to weasel-faced cock rockers Aerosmith, the other a substandard DS outing, Neversoft is fighting back with World Tour. This mirrors the Rock Band setup while promising a more realistic drum kit and feature-packed recording studio. Advantage Guitar Hero? Not if Harmonix has anything to do with it. So Rock Band 2, with an expandable drum kit and brand new game modes, is already warming up. Let battle commence. Rock Band, of course, did drums first, but coming second has its advantages, which, in Guitar Hero World Tour's case, is evolving the percussion setup to include two cymbal pads, giving five inputs plus a pedal. The challenge for Rock Band 2, then, is to match its cocky rival without alienating existing drum heroes.
Well, so the really cool thing for us with Rock Band 2's hardware is that we actually have expansion ports on the back of our drum set that let you attach three cymbals to your drum set. I know I've been playing drums for 14 years. I know we have, you know, over 85% of people at Harbox play an instrument. So we really are musicians first and game people second. But my drum set has three cymbals on it. I don't know how many drum sets you've seen with two cymbals on them. That's a question for, I guess, other people.
We actually have a lot of expandability. You plug in any drum kit to our game, you play it. I mean, you don't have to buy an Ion drum kit or some kind of halfway, half-baked version of a real drum kit. Use a real drum kit with our game. If you want to use a keyboard and map the drum and play the right notes for drums, you can do that. You can use one of those hand sonic drums. You can use any interface device that transmit on MIDI channel 10 in our game to trigger the drums. It could be a power glove.
One of the biggest issues for gamers, of course, is the price. After the PR disaster of Rock Band's European pricing, neither side is saying anything official. But if one living room Rocktacular isn't enough for you, and you're strapped for cash and space, there is a silver lining.
Our game works fine with a Rock Band 1 kit, just fine. We actually did extra work to make it work fine because, you know, we're aware that people don't always, they don't have a lot of money, might not want to buy a new kit. They might want to wait till their Rock Band kit breaks and then buy our kit.
We want all instruments to work with all instruments. We want people to have the choice to pick what they want to play. You know, if people want to play a Fender, we hope that they play a Fender. That's our brand. We love working with them. If people want to play a different guitar, they should have the ability to play that different guitar in the game.
If you have a Rock Band kit, we shrink the highway to 4 and we remap that to blue or green, whatever makes the best sense for the song.
I think there's a sort of a cap for how much plastic you can have at one given time, and we are very aware of that, which is why we're making our game backwards compatible with our first drum set, trying to make that drum set available to other people to program into their games, as well as making our drum set expandable with the cymbal expansion packs rather than static, and you have to buy a new kit on top of that if you want cymbals, things like that.
Ah, they're like one big happy rock family. Well, not quite. And Neversoft has some rather pointed views on whether Rock Band 2 is a fully realized sequel.
We obviously revealed ours much earlier than they did. I have a feeling there was an, oh shit, there's cymbals. How can we put cymbals on our kit?
Over to you.
That's been a question we've sort of been getting a little bit, you know, is it Rock Band 1.5? And we've really been saying, it might look like that on the surface, it might look like just more songs, but really the technology that we're pushing forward and some of the features that we've added, it's not just a title update, it really is a new game with a lot of really great stuff. So the most important of which is our Battle of the Bands mode, which really is kind of an industry standard for what we think music gaming should be in the future.
And the Rock Band team can bitch with the best of them, especially when it comes to the issue of authenticity.
We're musicians first, so our charts are all done by people who've been playing guitar for a very long time. They kind of know what it should feel like. You know, when you're playing a power chord, it should feel like a power chord, things like that. So we really go for authenticity first. So what we did, instead of saying we're going to make something artificially difficult and add notes where there aren't notes or add, you know, extra figuring that doesn't need to be there, we're going to find some songs that really justify having some shredding moments.
Downloadable content is the battleground for the long haul. And so far, Rock Band has outclassed its rival with the sheer volume of extra material released. But both have big plans for the future.
I mean, we actually are actually tying in with a few different artists to actually release albums day and date with our downloadable content. So Metallica will be our first one. Their new album will launch day and date on Guitar Hero. And then we have REM track pack at launch. We have a couple Jimi Hendrix packs you'll see right after launch. But beyond that, we have frequent downloads.
You know, we've sort of, again, set the standard with the amount of music that we sold through and that we offer as downloadable content with that weekly schedule that we've been so regimented about hitting. Like, we haven't missed a week yet. Every Tuesday there's been new music to play. We'll let kind of fans decide where they want to spend their money rather than forcing them to buy an entire disc of something that doesn't work with the rest of the universe.
We've had millions and millions and millions of downloads. A lot of that is because we've given a lot of free downloadable content out there. So we don't try to nickel and dime everybody on everything.
As we've seen, Rock Band 2 is pumping up the percussion to compete with World Tour. But one area where the new Guitar Hero is going solo is Music Studio. This lets you record and play back your own hits in-game, or download other gamers' top tracks via the GHTune service, which Activision Blizzard reckons could become the iTunes of games.
It's really powerful. I mean, we've got enough tools in there to allow you to create any style of music. There's just tons of different sounds, tons of different tools. Anything you really, really want and need, it's like a stripped-down version of Cubase or something on your console.
Harmonix, we're assured, is on the case. It just needs a little more rehearsal time.
In terms of a music creator, we've always been interested in that. You know, we've seen things like that, things like a MIDI music creator that we've done in older games like Amplitude, Frequency, like that genre of game. We think there's a certain level of success there. We're excited to see how it drives the industry forward in terms of the music gaming industry as it currently stands. And I think we have some very cool plans on how to do it in a bigger way that really works with all of our consumers.
So, now we have the basic blueprint for band brilliance. What's next? More instruments? Well, we've all heard the rumor about the keyboard, the Rock Band.
And we've always said, like, that would be really cool. How would you notate it? Like, how would you make it work on the screen? Like, there's, you know, a lot of questions that kind of come up philosophically because of that. And at that point, do you make a game that's centered entirely around an instrument, or do you kind of incorporate it into the, again, the bigger universe?
You know, you can easily run a double bass on our game. We have a future expandability for hi-hat control pedals. We could also, it'd be very easy for us to add other cymbals via the MIDI interface jack. With the MIDI jack, our game is we could expand it to as many drums and cymbals as humanly possible.
Right, so now we're up to speed on the great gaming battle of the bands. It's time for the final sales pitch. So why should we buy your game?
If you want to feel like a real rock star and you want to feel like the real world tour experience for people who know what it's like to play your instruments and give you an authentic music experience, you got to start with Harmonix. We're the guys who've been doing it for the longest. We know how it works the best.
I think our drum kit is vastly superior. It's velocity sensitive, not just hard and soft, but every range in between. It's a full MIDI drum kit, essentially. You know, we have huge names. We have, you know, like I said, Hendrix, Ozzy Osbourne, Van Halen, Eagles, Doors. You're not going to see any of those bands anytime soon in our competitors' products.
There's sort of no other choice to make. I don't see any other games with 500 songs by this year, do you?
There's really an endless supply of downloadable content that you have with World Tour that's driven from the user community.
Finally, since we're in Germany, we couldn't leave without asking the big question. Where's the Hoff?
You don't hassle the Hoff, and we do love the Hoff at Harmonix, so I think we should be doing more inquiry into that. I know one of our bathrooms has been decorated with David Hasselhoff posters for a little while now. We call it the Hoff. So to all the German fans, you know, stay tuned for Hasselhoff, hopefully.
I wish. He's got the best videos. Don't hassle the Hoff. Yeah, he's awesome. I can say in this game there's no Hoff.
Rock Band 2 releases on 360 in the US next month, with PS3, PS2 and Wii versions due before Christmas. With PS3 and PS2 versions of the original Rock Band yet to release in Europe, however, don't hold your breath for the sequel over here before 2009. Guitar Hero World Tour, meanwhile, is due on 360, PS3, PS2 and Wii on both sides of the Atlantic later this year. Ooh, decisions.
Well, yo, right now, kick the bass with a brother and let them know.
What? 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 What